Frasier, could you lend me 10 bucks?
What, did you leave your wallet home or something?
No, I gave the last of my money to this poor guy down in front of the building. He's an Australian tourist. He lost his wallet and he just needed $10.
So I could take a cab to the Australian consulate before it closes?
Yeah. How'd you know?
There is no Australian consulate in Seattle. Well, I got three people coming over for poker tonight. Two of them are cops. The third one's done time in jail. I'll bet you $5 you can't tell which one's the ex-con.
Hey, can I get in on the action?
No, of course you can.
Great. 10 bucks on your dad.
Now, the ground rules for tonight are that I'm not allowed to ask you any questions directly about your line of work, but whatever questions I do ask, you must answer truthfully.
Okay, Sherlock, you got center stage.
Well, I have sketched an accurate psychological profile of each one of you. And in so doing, I have come to the incontrovertible conclusion that the criminal among us can only be Frank!
Wrong. Frank's a highly decorated undercover cop.
Exactly! Just a little too obvious, you know. The broken vocabulary, the jailhouse pallor, the underdeveloped social skills.
Hey.
So, you tried to use psychology against me, did you? Threw a gender bender at me, thinking that I would just assume that a felon would naturally be a man. Well, I'm onto your little game, mister. The criminal among us is indeed the very wily Linda.
Nope.
Jimmy!
You're right.
Who was a jailhouse snitch?
Jimmy.
Jimmy's an ex-con.
Well, you certainly proved your point. I feel stupid as hell.
I feel rather a fool myself.
Well, why would you care one way or another?
Because I've agreed to go out with Jimmy tomorrow night.
No, you just can't go. That's all there is to it. Case closed.
Excuse me, Dad, if I can interrupt that self-righteous police mentality for a second, don't you believe in second chances?
I did, then we had Niles.
Well, I believe that when a man has paid his debt to society, he deserves a fresh start. I see no harm in her going out with him once.
Well, I do. She's not going.
I say she is.
I say she isn't.
She is not.
Me, gentlemen, but might I interject one tiny little thought into this conversation?
Of course, Daphne.
Belt up, both of you. It may have escaped your notice, but I happen to be a grown woman, and nobody has told me whom I might or might not date since I was a schoolgirl, and I didn't listen then. Now, when I've quite made up my mind what I plan to do about Jimmy, I'll let you know.
Not all criminals are recidivists. Mm. I've seen many cases where, after they've paid their debt to society, they've gone on to lead productive lives. Dad's just being narrow-minded. Mm.
Yes, I almost had to sedate him when Daphne announced she was going to go out with him.
Just tell me where they went.
Oh, someplace called the Topaz Room.
The Topaz Room? I thought the cops shut that place down after the last shooting.
I'll drive.
Even today. But I certainly do enjoy it. You, gentlemen. And now, if you'll excuse me, I'm going to attempt to use the ladies' room without touching anything.
Come on, Niles. We've got your little walk on the wild side. Let's get out of here.
What about Daphne?
Well, come on. You heard what she did to Jimmy. Think how mad she'll be if she should find us here.
You're right. Best make ourselves scarce. Oh, good Lord. There she is.
Oh, God. I'm sorry.
What the hell are you doing?
I'm sorry. I was just trying to...
Maybe miss that shot.
I'm sorry.
I had 200 bucks riding on that shot. You owe me $200.
Well, I'd gladly pay you, but I don't have that kind of cash on me.
Or even if he did, it would be absurd to bring it into a place like this, you know, with the kind of element that you could run into.
Maybe I could write you a check?
My element don't take checks. I think maybe we should take these guys outside and wise them up.
Oh, I don't really think that's necessary at all.
Oh, my goodness. What are you two doing here?
We might ask you the same thing. This happens to be one of our favorite haunts. Actually, Maris and I had our rehearsal dinner here.
Excuse me, lady, but it seems like your friends can't seem to come up with the 200 they owe me, so I'm gonna have to, pardon my French, beat the crap out of them.
Listen, I'm a psychiatrist. Maybe we could take this out in sessions. You know, it seems you have some control.
Outside.
Wait! I have money.
Hey, I don't mind taking your money, but I was kind of looking forward to pulping this guy.
Yeah, well, we won't quibble. If I miss, you can pulp him.